What a class act to follow. He's the best. That was terrific, Al. Good evening. Before I begin, let me thank Hedy and Arthur Goldberg for chairing this wonderful event and for their leadership of the community every single day. All of you. So tonight we come together as a federation, a community to celebrate our accomplishments, and of course to recognize Al Gortz and Ann Jacobson, the two most recent links in the chain of our top lay leadership. Where would we be today without the wisdom, guidance, and hard work of our board chairs who have brought us through this 36 years to this exciting point in our federation's history? That several of them are with us tonight is a testament to the enduring strength of our organization. But I couldn't do it without calling out my friend Ellen Sarnoff. Who led this organization through dark times with grace and fortitude, and without whom I would not be standing here before you. Thank you, Ellen. I also have to add my own tribute to Al Gortz, on whom I've relied for so much, even before he became chair of our board. I can personally assure you that he has the knowledge, wisdom, commitment, and diplomacy that are unsurpassed. I'm grateful for these years of working so closely with one of our federation's founders and our exceptional leaders. Thanks, Al. And yet, a team's strength over time is reliant on its deep bench. And folks, in this regard, we're not just strong, we're unbeatable. A year ago, we welcomed Ann Jacobson as our first chair designate. We'll hear from Ann at the end of this evening, which I promise will be the shortest annual meeting in years. So, I'm not done. So I ask, and I fully anticipate, that you all remain in your seats until our closing. Ann's journey to becoming our board chair has taken her through diverse areas of our federation. So I know that many of you, like me, have known the incredible rewards of working with her. Among her many roles here, Ann served as chair of that unmistakable incubator of leadership, Women's Philanthropy. And yes, while our leadership is strong, unfortunately, this past year, we were deeply saddened to lose three of our greatest philanthropists and inspirations. The unparalleled Larry Phillips, the visionary Toby Wyman Palchuk, and community pioneer Mildred Levine. We miss them dearly, as we do all of our supporters who have left us this year. And yet, we all know we could never do what we do, and do it so well, without our outstanding staff. Our COO, an ESPN lover, obviously. Mel Lowell is my trusted partner. He's also been the driving force, heart and soul, behind Sinai Residence for the past 8 years. From a vision to the beautiful new residential community on our North Campus. Thank you, Mel, for being here every day as my true brother in arms. And I know that many of you, as I do, depend faithfully on Marla Weiseggers, our Executive Vice President. She seamlessly fulfills so many of our vital roles and responsibility. Marla is always our voice of reason and reality, calm, compassionate, and powerful personal connection. To Mel and Marla, thank you for everything you do for our Federation every day. And I must acknowledge our senior professional staff, the most talented, dedicated team a CEO could hope for. And I couldn't be more proud of our entire staff, whose dedication and support of our mission drives our success throughout all areas of our federation. And of course, as I'm sure many of you have wondered, Stacy, where would we be for our annual meeting without Stacy Raymer, our Director of Governance and my Senior Executive Assistant? I also have to recognize an important new colleague at Sinai Residences. As many of you have worked with him knows, Sinai's amazing executive director, Chris Newport, is an absolute dynamo. He's a master of multitasking with vendors, residents, co-workers, and anyone else involved with getting Sinai Residence up and running smoothly. And a shout out is in order to all my professional colleagues and their lay leaders here who are from our agencies, our schools, our synagogues. The fact that there are far too many here tonight to call out individually is a sign of our extraordinary Jewish community. But you'll take a look around the room, and you'll see them, including the heads of the agencies on our campus that for so long have been part of the bedrock of our community. I'm also thrilled to see so many of our local rabbis and synagogue leaders here tonight, because we have no more important partners towards strengthening this community. Friends, it's hard to believe that this is the fourth time I've come before you to articulate a vision for our Federation and this amazing community we live in. Each year, it's been my honor and privilege to stand here and report the successes of our innovations and our hard work. And tonight is no exception. You know what's going on. You can see it. You can feel it all around you. We're no longer largely a snowbird community, but one where businesses have been built and families are raising children. Yes, we've become a mature community of substance and depth and of multiple generations, but we've become so much more. Ours is a community where we cross the usual boundaries of neighborhood and denomination regularly and eagerly to celebrate, to advocate, to learn, to care, and to help. And other communities around the country have taken notice, and they're borrowing from our playbook. And tonight is indeed a time to celebrate our accomplishments. Our pride and our spirits are deservedly high. But as leaders of the community, it's also time to recognize together that the greatest challenge that lies ahead, the continuing major demographic shift and its impact on our donor base. See, we're a big Jewish community with big human needs to meet for so many people who must depend upon us. Because tens of thousands of our seniors are alone in this community, and they're growing older, and they're growing more frail, and they're outliving their resources. Because neighboring families in crisis are unable to cope emotionally or pay their bills and have nowhere else to turn. Because elderly Jews isolated in the war-torn, frigid Ukraine winter deserve to eat and have heat in their room. And we're committed to doing our part for our Jewish family in Israel and overseas. But we can't meet those needs the way we used to, folks. Friend, it's my job to tell you that it's going to take all of us here in this room, at the very core of our community. It's up to us to reach higher for more creative solutions, to reach further so that everyone knows the importance of what we do and the rewards of being part of this incredible community. Of course, leadership is key to seizing our future, and our efforts to populate that deep bench are working. Our committees, our cabinets, our boards include people of all ages from across the community. Looking further ahead, we know that absolutely vital to ensuring a bright future for our Jewish community and our people is investment in our next generation of Jews. As a mature Jewish community, it's time to deepen our commitment to connecting our young people with their faith, their culture, their heritage, and their homeland for the long term. Our future depends upon it. And yes, our community boasts a remarkable and growing diversity of outstanding Jewish day schools. Both on and off our campus, they are the key to the next generation of Jewish families and leaders. Our day schools are also significant to making South Palm Beach County a top quality destination Jewish community that brings us new and engaged residents. But it's time for us to chart a course toward a day not far off when day school education is affordable and accessible for every local family that desires it. And toward a day when Jewish camping is also understood for its powerful impact and brought into the reach for all of our families. We need to keep connecting our young people to Israel by filling our community birthright buses, by expanding our March of the Living classes and providing more immersive Israel experiences. And we need to build upon the success of our JCRC's College Prep Israel Advocacy Program training that drew 200 diverse high school students here in Zimmern Hall to our campus just a few months ago. We're on it, but we know what the stakes are high, and we know it builds Jewish continuity. And we know it's time to do more, and it's up to us, all of us, working together to get the word out there to the neighbors who could join us in making a difference. Israel and our global Jewish family have always been at the core of Federation's mission. For decades, we've been bringing the community together to provide ongoing and emergency support in advocacy and rallies, to learn and to visit. I know some of you felt that we should be doing more, and we are. Our community is united in its commitment to our brothers and sisters in Israel, who even in a time of relative peace, live in fear not only of rockets, but of stabbings and car rammings. And we must be there for Jews around the globe who fear for their freedoms and their lives, They too deserve a bridge to a new life in Israel. Over the last 2 years, we've increased our allocation for Jewish needs in Israel and other countries overseas. And this year, we'll begin allocating these dollars in some exciting new ways. And of course, there could be no better proof of the power of a shared travel to tie us to the land and to the people of Israel than last November's Spirit of Israel community mission. We looked into the future of our homeland and how we can be a part of it. From a myriad of Jewish backgrounds and across generations, we learned from each other and we grew together. I've been to Israel about 30 times, mommy. But traveling with my mother made this trip a pinnacle for me, and I know I also speak for Rich Steinberg, who traveled to Israel with his father as well. Stay tuned. We're ramping up our missions for the future, and we have a director of Israel engagement to help get far more of you, your friends, and your neighbors on board. From its earliest years, our community has been committed to serving families with special needs. But well before we participated in a recent community special needs survey, we knew we needed to step it up. So I'm excited to announce that in the coming months, we'll be working with our community partners and outside experts to create a blueprint for our comprehensive special needs services in our Jewish community. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Emily Grabowski for her leadership, for her advice, for her insights, and for her knowledge as we begin this important process. Of course, vital to our future is our Jacobson Jewish Community Foundation, led by Rich Steinberg. Yes, recently it's been growing well, with over $80 million in assets. Our number of endowments keep increasing as more people understand the value of planned giving and commit to this community. But I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that we have quite a way to go to reach the levels of older Jewish communities. So look for us to continue our full court press. And if you haven't made a planned gift, it's time, folks. And if you have, it's time to reach out and let others around you know the importance and rewards of leaving their legacy. Last year, we shared the news that the Grinspoon Foundation would begin supporting our Federation's Create a Jewish Legacy effort throughout the community. 1 year later, I'm thrilled to report that the Life and Legacy program has already resulted in 15 local synagogues, schools, and agencies and organizations obtaining 293 commitments from 234 donors with an estimated value of $33.2 million for our community. And the CJL initiative has brought home the value of our Federation and our foundation far into our community. Through our JCRC, we continually advocate for agency funding and other Jewish interests. We're thrilled to report that just among the successes of the Florida legislative session that just ended were increased dollars for Holocaust survivor assistance at JFS and significant first-time funding for pre-employment training at JARC. And yes, the legislature also passed a groundbreaking anti-BDS bill that prohibits state and local governments from investment in companies that boycott Israel. And just last week, in this room, the governor signed that bill to stop the dangerous BDS forces. So here's an editorial comment. With our government partnerships strong and thriving, I have to interject my own side note here. While we are immersed, if not drowning in political news, each and every day, it's vital for our Federation to remain neutral and maintain strong bipartisan relationships. If for nothing else, and nothing other than the sake of those who depend upon us, it is upon each of us to avoid the silly rhetoric that has marked the presidential campaign so far. So by now, you should be able to tell I'm making an even bigger than usual argument for engaging more and more members of our community in our work. And I hope by now you recognize that is absolutely essential to our future. Thanks to Deborah and Larry Silver, our new Center for Jewish Engagement means we are able to reach more of our neighbors. We're bringing them into our community's wealth of opportunities to enrich their Jewish journeys as we strengthen Jewish South Palm Beach County. If you could keep up with Rabbi Brody, which none of you can, you know just how many Jewish connections our CJE is making every day. And with its first big events, we know we're just scratching the surface. And in just a few months, we'll be helping to bring Moshe House, an innovative young adult engagement model, to our community. Moshe House will provide a home for a core group of residents, ages 22 to 30, who share their eagerness to create a hub of Jewish life for their peers. And also through engagement, we've been holding a wide array of free events, large and small, to reach newcomers. From last month's conversation with Alan Dershowitz that brought together 1,000 locals, to parlor meetings in private homes, and everything in between, including last week's Super Sunday with its Good Deeds Day project for hundreds of hands-on volunteers. And this Sunday, PJ Library will celebrate its third birthday here. This past year, PJ brought together 5,000 children, parents, and grandparents for activities around the community. And this past year, PJ Our Way got underway for older children. With our regular parade of campus tours, we hope that soon we'll no longer be able to say we're the best-kept secret in Boca. And friends, we could see the results from our efforts and all the new donors to our levels out of our annual campaign led by Larry Feldman. In recent years, we've been emphasizing a growing number of benchmark levels accessible to people throughout our community, including our King David Society and major donors, Lions and Pomegranates, Men's Division, BNP Cabinet, and more. And how fabulous that in January, our new neighbors began moving into Sinai Residences. And they're as thrilled to be here as we are to have them. In fact, our professional staff is helping them become an active part of our Federation community. A huge shout out to those visionary, dedicated leaders who have served on the Board of Managers over these years to bring this superb project to fruition. Please join me in congratulating each and every one of them. Of course, Sinai Residences is doing more than providing the finest in senior living in a Jewish environment. By monetizing our Federation's vacant land, for decades, Sinai will be generating funds to help us meet the challenges of today and tomorrow. But in the midst of our much-deserved celebration, as I wrap up my remarks, let me be crystal clear. Sinai alone cannot offset the demographic challenges and community needs we face ahead. It is absolutely incumbent upon us here at the very core, the heart and soul of our beloved Jewish community, to bring the story of who we are and what we do into the homes of far more of our local residents. And make no mistake, our story is the best one they could hear. It's a story of an organization like no other, with the capacity to gather resources and wisely direct them when and where are most needed by our neighbors and our people. And folks, it's up to us, because no one knows better than we in this room how much is at stake. No one knows better how to tell this story, and no one knows better how to share the wealth of opportunities and the profound rewards of helping our Jewish family as part of a caring community. So in closing, I ask you to ask yourself, what will you do to make the case to your family, friends, neighbors, and colleagues about the wisest, most effective investment they can make to ensure our Jewish family's well-being today and our Jewish future tomorrow? And rest assured, we'll help you answer that question. It's been my privilege to speak before you, and I look forward to working together, healthy, strong, and united into the years ahead. Thank you.